Well, welcome to this session, UGRC 110 Academic Writing. And in this session, session 8, we want to look at how to write introductions. How to write introductions. Great. Your introduction gives a very first impression to your readers and assures them that your essay is worth reading. From this, you note that introductions are very crucial to understanding any piece of work that is properly done. So your introduction is your first point of contact between the reader and your work. You will not be there, but your writing will be there. So for this session, the objectives are: note the importance of introductions, identify the parts of an introduction, write an introduction to an essay. The key topics to be covered in this session are as follows. 1, the thesis statement, the position of the thesis statement. So we'll focus on the thesis statement and the position of the thesis statement. Right, so the thesis statement. A thesis statement contains the central idea or ideas that your essay seeks to develop in an essay. So every essay should have a central idea that it wishes to develop. And the central idea is what you are referring to as the thesis statement. In a way, the thesis statement can be likened to the topic sentence of the paragraph. It can be likened to the topic sentence of the paragraph, which summarizes the central idea of a paragraph. But now let us look at how the thesis statement in the following paragraph provides focus to the essay we are writing on. The topic here is, should Ghana go hippic? Should Ghana go hippic? Right, and I'll read for you. The term hippic is translated to mean a highly indebted poor country. This term is applied to countries which have a huge foreign debt. Most countries with huge foreign debts are found in Africa, some parts of Asia, and South America. Most often, poor countries are also referred to as third world countries. It is the prerogative of a poor country to declare itself hippic. Ghana is a third world country with a huge foreign debt. And of late, there has been this debate as to whether Ghana should declare itself hippic or not. Ghana has a lot to gain by declaring itself hippic. Now I want you to note the line that is in bold. The last line that is in bold. So the sentence that is written in boldface shows the writer as having taken a stance on the topic under discussion. This is what we are referring to as the thesis statement in this instance. Let me go back to it. So let us look at the part that is written in boldface. And let me add some more sentences to make it more complete. This essay will therefore look into the area of hippic and argue that hippic is good for Ghana. For the purposes of this analysis, this essay will look at the economic, political, social, and cultural advantages of Ghana going hippic. That should be the full one. Now let us look at this again. Now, the part, as I said earlier, the part that has been written in boldface shows that the writer is has taken a stance on the topic of the discussion. This is what we are calling the thesis statement. Now, after that boldface, the writer goes on to tell us that he's going to look at an argument that hippic is good for Ghana, and he's going to look at the political, the social, and then the economic advantages of going hippic. The point being made here is that in an introductory paragraph, There are two main points. There are two main parts. These are the background information and the thesis statement. We have the background or explanatory statements and the thesis statement. Those constitute the two parts of the introduction. Let us examine some examples of a clear and effective thesis statement. If, for instance, our topic is the state of the Ghana Police Service today, let us assume that we have omitted the background information on this topic, and the following is our thesis statement. So I'm saying that we are assuming that if the topic that we are interrogating, the general topic is the state of the Ghana Police Service today, that is the general topic, and we are assuming that we have written the background information and everything, and we are now focusing on the thesis statement, what will we say to sort of capture what we want to write? Let us look at this one, saying that the police service today is completely different from what it used to be. Now, my contention here is that obviously this thesis statement has a lot to do with the topic the police service in Ghana today. But it does not tell us the nature of the change. If it says it's not what it used to be, we don't know the nature of the change. It is therefore vague. It needs to be revised. As a topic, a thesis statement, it needs to be revised. So we have to specify the nature of the change. So let us consider the following revised version. The change in the Ghana Police Service comes especially with the entrance of university-educated men and women into the service to bring about efficiency. The change in the Ghana Police Service comes especially with the entrance of university-educated men and women into the service to bring about efficiency. So the previous one says that the change, the police service is not what it used to be. Now, we are not sure of the change, but now this second thesis statement has become more specific, saying that it is the entrance of university graduates that has brought about some efficiency into the police service. So the change has come from their entrance. You will observe that from the above revised thesis statement that this is more specific than what we had, and efficiency is a key factor here in this revised thesis statement. Now, let us try to write an effective introduction on an essay on the topic, the role of the media in Ghana's democracy. The role of the media in Ghana's democracy. Ensure that your introduction contains useful background information before the thesis statement. Let us note especially that the thesis statement is very, very crucial in the writing. We have equated it to the topic sentence of the paragraph. But note that once the paragraph is controlled by the topic sentence, the thesis statement controls the entire essay. So you may look at the topic sentence as a subset of the thesis statement. So the thesis statement is bigger compared to the topic sentence that is smaller and limited to a paragraph, whereas the thesis statement is for the whole of the essay. Now let us look at the position of the thesis statement. The position of the thesis statement. Where do we normally find the thesis statement? Say that generally, the thesis statement comes towards the end of the introduction, that is after the background information has been provided. This order is effective because the background information sets the frame of reference within which the thesis statement is understood. So the one about HIPIC, we talked about the fact that we defined what the terms, what HIPIC means. We talked about places where you can find HIPIC countries. We talked about the fact that it is the prerogative of any nation to declare itself a HIPIC. Before we connected this whole idea of HIPIC to Ghana and then made the profound statement that Ghana has a lot to gain by going HIPIC. So the background information generally should come before the thesis statement so that we contextualize why we are making such a we are taking such a position or taking such a claim. All right? This order of making the thesis statement come after the background information is effective because the background information sets a frame of reference in which the thesis statement is understood. With thesis statement coming at the latter part of the introduction, both the writer and the reader are focused on the issues to be developed in the next part of the essay, which is the body paragraphs. So we are placing the thesis statements so close to the body paragraphs that it is easy for the reader to look at what is being discussed here and connect it to what is the thesis statement. It's very important that way, right? Now, it's important as a writer to have what you call a working thesis statement if you have not fashioned it for it to be taught. So a thesis statement is not easily composed by beginning writers. So in order to not get stuck, you have to adopt what is normally referred to as a working or tentative thesis statement. The working thesis statement will help you go ahead and develop your idea so that you are not affected by what is known as the writer's block. All right? You want to finish your essay by a certain time. If you want to start with the thesis statement, you may be there for a very long time. So you don't want to be stuck. So you can have a working thesis statement and you go ahead and develop the ideas that you have related to the topic. All right? After your essay has been drafted, you may consider revising the working thesis statement. You may consider revising the working statement for it to capture exactly what you have captured, you have discussed or analyzed or argued in the essay in order to have a clearer and therefore a good thesis statement. So we are saying that the bigger work is done in the body paragraph. Your argumentation and your discussion and everything takes place in the body paragraphs. So we should concentrate on that. And if issues come up within the discussion or analysis, it is easier for us to work or amend the thesis statement than to stay on the thesis statement to write and write and write for it to see what it will reflect or the effect it will have on the body paragraphs. We are advising that rather let's work on the body paragraphs with a working thesis statement, and after that, we can revise the thesis statement. Okay? Great. Now, let us look at ways by which we can start the introduction. So, contingent on what type of writing you are doing, you don't have to use the same approach or method of writing the introduction. The essay is written in the university environment is essentially to show scholarship. So if one sticks to one way of writing essays, it becomes so boring or predictable. So there's the need to vary the writing of our introduction depending on the nature of the topic that we are writing about. Some of the ways by which you can write an introductory paragraph to an essay include, one, begin with a startling remark or statistics. So you can begin with a startling remark or statistics. You can ask a question. You can challenge a widely held assumption or opinion. You can use an anecdote or describe a scene. You can use an appropriate quotation. You can explain keywords in the topic for discussion. Now, having said these, begin with a startling remark or statistics, ask a question, challenge a widely held assumption or opinion, use an anecdote or describe a scene, use an appropriate quotation, explain keywords. Let us see how we can do some of these. All right? Now let us look at this example, an example of using a startling remark or statistics. It is estimated that every day 200 people get infected by the HIV virus in Ghana. Ghana is one of the countries in Africa with a low prevalence rate, So one can imagine the case in countries with high prevalence rates. The HIV/AIDS pandemic has affected many African countries negatively by weakening their labor force, by rendering many children parentless, and by creating abject poverty. Now, if this issue of the HIV/AIDS pandemic is new to you, and you get to hear that 200 people get infected every day, it will be so shocking to you that you can imagine the number of people that get infected within the shortest possible time. And this is what we are referring to as an example of a startling remark. Every day, 200 people get infected by the HIV/AIDS virus, and then HIV/AIDS has a way of breaking the labor force, creating parentless societies, and then creating abject poverty. This has a way of giving you a shock. So we call this an example of startling remark, and it is one of the methods by which you can start your introduction. All right? My students, we have been looking at how to write the introduction, and then we paid attention to what is called a thesis statement. We are saying that in an introduction, we have two main parts. The general noises, also called the background or explanatory information, and the thesis statement. The thesis statement is the lifeline of the whole essay. It is that which controls whatever can be said in the essay. We have said that it is a bigger version of the topic sentence, since the topic sentence derives its source from the thesis statement. And generally speaking, the thesis statement is written towards the end of the introductory paragraph, so that it is close to the body paragraph for easy reference and to help the writer to know what he has set out to do. And then we have also looked at ways by which we can start the introduction. And one that I've introduced just as of now is how to use startling remarks or statistics to start your essay or start your introductory paragraph. So I'll see you again soon.